Natya Rasa Lahari is a beautiful concept brought to you by Rasa Ramana Sundarthi Alia. It is a coming together of different thought processes with regard to each one's practice of this great art. Very senior Natyacharyas come and share their own journey, the ups and downs, and their deep connect with the beautiful art.
If you are a good patram, whatever your role you do, it'll have its spark. People will notice you.
The purpose of this ballet, I would say, is to say that self-knowledge is the purpose of Natya.
The master has allowed me to experience Natya as all-inclusive, all-pervasive, and being the Shiva Tattva or the Nataraja Tattva in its ultimate form.
It is only those who are just soaked in this ocean who can experience that ananda, which is cannot be measured in any times, in any terms, materially or otherwise.
Their current work and their past work is shared on this beautiful platform, and it enriches everyone's life to be able to connect to our own art in a better possible manner, and therefore practice it better and experience it better.
I would like to shortlist very few of my favorites that have been churned out of Devaneya this far. Allow me to briefly tell you about them, and then we could play the video clips for you. The first one was I Am Madras, which was, of course, as the name itself suggests, very interesting, where we humanized the city of Chennai. Getting Kathak musicians and instruments in Chennai is always a challenge. So a lot of times when it is not for a commercial use, we do use music that is already in albums, taking the permission of the required people or companies, and giving due credits every time. So the first one that I would like to talk about was I Am Madras, where we humanize the city of Chennai using Mahakavi Bhardiyar's Payumoli Nianakku sung in the very, very soulful voice of Bombay Jayashree, where we had also added and combined a few rhythmic interludes and a poem in English that I had penned. In our interpretation of this song, the city eulogizes its dweller as a lover, and the dweller, in turn, reciprocates. We characterize Chennai as a lover. The ensemble of costumes worn by the dancers in our presentation were Madras checks, temple jewelry, and the famous Madras half sari. They reflected Madras, or now Chennai, in a subtle yet very defining manner. Likewise, in other productions, we combined Kathak with Kuchipudi and also Kathak with Tappatam, the folk dance of dancing drummers. One of the other early trysts with characterization was an English poem again, titled Kuhu Kuhu. When my siblings and I were young children, my mother used to tell us a very beautiful and heart-wrenching story about two koyal birds and why the koyal sings in the monsoon. And many decades later, I penned a poem out of that story and set it to music to pass on, and to share rather, the love for storytelling that she, my mother, passed on to me. And this song was a tribute to my mother, and also to love as human beings understand it. The gist of the story is that there are two koyal birds, Ku and Su. And they built their nest of love with togetherness and joy. And they were the happiest pair anyone would notice. But a relentless gale one night completely battered and shattered their nest, and they were separated forever. The story has it that on every stormy day and night, Su calls out his beloved's name. Coo! He calls out, in the hope that someday he shall be heard. The song ends with a message. His shattered soul cry is so beautiful that it brings music to our unseeing hearts and ears. Even through his pain, as he cries for his beloved, for us it is, he may remain unquenched, but for us it is a message of the monsoon which shall quench our thirst. So be like music to others, even through your pain, was the message that we were trying to give through this. And we humanize the birds as with human characteristics that we as humans understand. The next one would be a ghazal. In these days of the most horrific crimes against women, we chose a ghazal of the famous Pakistani poet Faiz Ahmed Faiz as a prayer for peace and respect for womanhood. Midway through the ghazal, and that's the part that we will be showing you, to the right of the stage, we had the lovers emoting their feelings. And to the left of the stage, we depicted a visual of the social issue of flesh trade. The song was Mujhse Pehli Si Mohabbat, Mere Mehboob Na Mang, a love song which we interpreted to use to portray what the poet was actually trying to say, speaking about one of the issues that was breaking his heart, and that was of flesh trade. Our most recent production was a bilingual dance drama in English and Hindi titled Love Songs of a Gypsy Spirit, which we premiered just this year. It was extremely successful, thanks to the grace of God. It took me many years to get down to doing it. I've always wanted to portray Mirabai, and I really sunk into her being to be able to do this. But it took me, as I was telling again, Ambikaji, years to get down to doing it, because I'm slow at these things. I don't know how to rush into anything. So that's why I'm a little nervous about the time frame too. It was a fantastic experience. Love Songs of a Gypsy Spirit was a very fantastic experience. It traced the evolution of Mirabai from childhood till when she merges into her lord or into the elements, who can ever tell. But it was, the experience was of teaching students and senior dancers the intricacies of character play, of each and every role being extremely important. And if one role fails, all, the entire story fails and falls completely flat like a pack of cards. And the more important thing was, it was nice to teach them to leave the character with the audience rather than carrying it about with themselves like a wrap. So perhaps that was what I learned from Pativrata Devi Kannagi. From gods and goddesses to different genres of dance and combinations of dance, all forms get depicted to finally happily collapse into the formless eternal bliss. Shivoham, Shivoham. I would like to end by saying that in a dancer, ecstasy is, it reveals the Atma. It reveals what's inside and what's in and around you. Like the petals of a lotus that unfurl one by one by one. The layers that can just come off with absolute ecstasy. Perseverance and dedication strengthen the body and the mind towards the flawless technique that you have to learn, which is again years of sadhana and practice. Not easy, and does not come as a blessing to everybody. But at such a point of beauty, when you have arrived at the ecstasy and the flawless technique, if there is pride or ownership over this blessing that you have as your own, then somewhere it would dull the divine grace. But humility, sincerity, natural, it is absolutely the best adornment of a dancer. So I would definitely tell all dancers, young dancers, to adorn that, to wear that jewel all the time, to practice being who you are and letting the roles do their job. Please do watch the videos. And if you have any questions for me, I would be very happy to try to answer them for you. I would take this moment to thank Ambikaji for this opportunity once again to share my work with all of you. My admiration and best wishes are with Rasa, as always. As part of the Rasa tradition, Ambika gifted me this sari, painted by the children of Rasa, 3 days ago when I had already planned my sari and all the color combinations and everything. I was a little... For one minute, the thought came, ayo, what will I do? Then I said, okay, let the sari come. And when the sari came, I was calling you, but we were playing cat and mouse on the phone. We weren't able to reach each other. My tears were flowing, and I'm not just simply saying that. My tears were flowing. Those who know me know how easily they flow. So it was love. There's love in every bit of it. This blouse, I just found it. Everything matched. It matched better than what I was trying to match. So when everything comes out of love and sincerity and without much thought process about this has to be done this way and that has to go that way, everything falls harmoniously into place. That's the way of the Lord. Saying that, I will let you watch the videos, and after that we can take it forward if we have time. Thank you very much. Namaskaram. Priya and Ashmini, Shankari, Sweta, Avni, my team, thank you very much for helping me through with the audiovisuals.
Yadina nunakku. City where the girl in me grew. This city where my first love bloomed. This city which toughened innocence to strength. This city in which I lost and gained. This city in which my heart wept and laughed. I visit one more time today to be welcomed with open arms again. Oh, my city. I am you. You are me. I am Madras.
Fatal day, a tremendous storm blew their way. They fought the relentless gale until their wings, tired and frail, surrendered to destiny's cruel game.
In these days of the most horrific crimes against women,
This ghazal comes to you with a prayer for peace and respect to womanhood. It also is a ghazal which shows us that men are sensitive too. But for the vile deeds of some, the entire gender is often maligned. Mujhse pehli si mohabbat mere mehboob na maang, sung in the unparalleled voice of Begum Noor Jahan.
I want that doll. I want that doll.
Hush, Meera. What are you doing? Please forgive her, Holy One. I do not know what has come over her.
Do not apologize, O Mother. She is just a child. This doll is no ordinary doll, Meera. It is an idol of Lord Krishna, to whom I pray every day and night. I take him with me everywhere. He is the only truth. All else is Maya. Thus, I cannot part with this idol.
Ma, who is my groom?
You already have your groom in Krishna. See how you cling to him all day?
These words became imprinted on Meera's heart and soul. Thereon, she became completely wedded to her Lord.
They say, I'm to be married to Rana Bhojraj, son of Raja Sangram Singh Sisodia of Chittorgarh. Don't they know I'm married to you? Won't you show up and take me away? Are you tearing me away from you? How can that be? Are you so naive, my Krishna? My Krishna? Don't you know that I'm irremovable from you? ¶¶